Hey folks, it's me on Wrong Radio Show 70. Check out one of my old bands I did. The name of the band is Wild Band Hickok. It's with old friends of mine, and Chris M. Bowling. So anyway, check out this song from Wild Band Hickok. It's called Blood on the Teepee. At the edge of the field of vines, and she dove in and dove out with a teenage rabbit in her mouth. By the time I got down there, the rabbit took its last two breaths. Now, I want to back up in the story, the true part of it. The teenage rabbit was a real wise ass. A real fucking punk. And the cat, she mind her business all day long. And that rabbit would drop little turds and throw them at the cat. Cat knew it. She said, it's just a youngster. And then she really kind of got tired of it one day because she had a headache. She asked the rabbit, "Hey boy, please, Please stop ridiculing me. The rabbit was a wise ass. He said, fuck you, lady. These nuts, he says. And she looked at him, licked her paws, and growled a little bit. And she said, motherfucker, if I catch you, I'll fucking kill you. Eat your fucking ears, your nose, then your lips, and then I'd crunch your fucking face in my jaw, and then I'll crush your skull and get to your brain, and I'll eat your fucking head, and I'll leave the carcass on the goddamn sidewalk, you fucking punk! And the rabbit said, grumpy old bitch, fuck off. She said, all right, I'll fix you. One of these days, I'll fix you. So the next day, he did it again. Threw shit at her. Rabbit turds. She got up and went to the other side of the house. She watched from a distance. And when that rabbit was at the edge, and he made his way in and had the back towards her, she went down to the edge of that field, from the grass to the field of vines, and slightly thicketed. She set her rear paws into the earth. She got ready for the pounce. She dove up. Right down into a hole of the vines in the field. And she came right back out. With a rabbit in her mouth. That punk-ass rabbit. Oh, he begged and screamed, please let me go. I'm sorry, mama. He kicked. She tightened with her jaws and teeth into his neck and crunch. And by the time I got to him, he took his last two breaths, and I said, I'm sorry. And I walked away to go turn the sprinklers on, because it was hot and dry. And when I came back, she was crunching into his face, and his ears were already gone. The dogs were barking to get out, and I had to go and make sure that the door was secure, because it's known to be pushed open. And it was secured. So I went back to the cat and the rabbit. And when I got back, his head was gone, and all it was a teenage boy's rabbit carcass, headless, underneath my Chevy truck. And she lay next to him and licked her paws and looked so relaxed and proud. I took a shovel and I heaved his body off into the thicket of the field of the vines. Later that night, his mother and his father and his little sister and brother went looking for him, found him about 15 feet from the edge, laying there, headless, carcass. Ants started to eat his toes. And they cried as well as they should have. It's just nature. It's all it is. Completely natural. Was a story of nature by Ryan L. Carlson on Wrong Radio Show 70.